Oh my god. SpaceX finally released the most awaited footage of Ship 30 splashed down from Buoy Cam. NASA's SLS contract extension may delay Artemis 2. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. SpaceX has long been working toward achieving a successful flight of the Starship Super Heavy system, just as depicted in their released renders. On October 13th, 2024, they finally reached a major milestone in this journey, marking a significant advancement in the development of their Starship system. The fifth flight test of the fully integrated Starship system marked an exciting leap forward, showcasing a range of technical improvements and operational advances. While much of the attention was focused on the dramatic catch of Booster 12 by the chopstick arms, one of the real key highlights of the test was the controlled splashdown of Ship 30 in the Indian Ocean. Although the live stream didn't show every angle of the splashdown, SpaceX recently released new footage captured from a buoy cam, giving us a closer look at this momentous event. During the live stream of the flight test, SpaceX offered only brief footage of Ship 30's splashdown, showing just the final moment when the spacecraft touched the surface of the Indian Ocean. This left many of us craving more detailed visuals of the splashdown. Fortunately, SpaceX has now released the long-awaited buoy cam footage, which provides a full view of the vehicle's controlled entry and landing. The buoy cam, strategically placed in the splashdown zone, offers a unique perspective on the precision of Starship's descent and landing. The footage captured Ship 30's splashdown from a previously unseen angle, showing the vehicle's smooth, controlled approach as it neared the ocean. The ability to land Starship with such precision, despite the extreme conditions of reentry and descent, demonstrates the effectiveness of the vehicle's landing systems and the continued success of SpaceX's iterative design and testing approach. SpaceX's use of a buoy cam to capture footage of Ship 30's splashdown was extremely helpful for both the Starship team and viewers. Positioned in the ocean at the designated splashdown zone, the buoy cam provided a unique perspective of the vehicle's descent and landing. The buoy cam footage is more than just a visual spectacle. It serves a practical purpose as well. By capturing the exact moment of splashdown, the footage provides SpaceX engineers with critical data that complements telemetry and onboard sensor readings. This visual confirmation allows the team to assess the performance of the landing systems with greater precision, helping them refine and improve future iterations of Starship. In the footage, we can see the moment when Ship 30 touches down in the ocean with remarkable accuracy. The landing was nearly flawless, despite minor burn-through on one of the control flaps. This level of precision is a testament to the robustness of SpaceX's flight control systems and further validates the vehicle's ability to perform exact landings, a crucial capability for future missions where precision will be key. You know, one of the standout moments of the fifth Starship flight test was the execution of the flip maneuver, a critical step in the vehicle's descent sequence. As Starship re-enters the atmosphere from space, it descends horizontally to take advantage of its aerodynamic design, but it must eventually flip to a vertical orientation for a controlled landing. This flip maneuver is a complex and highly coordinated sequence of events that involves precise control of the vehicle's aerodynamic surfaces and engine burns. During this test, Ship 30 reached an altitude of approximately 212 kilometers before starting its descent toward the designated splashdown zone in the Indian Ocean. After re-entry, the vehicle slowed down to subsonic speeds, at which point it executed the flip maneuver. This was made possible through the use of Starship's large flaps, which help stabilize the spacecraft as it transitions from horizontal flight to vertical descent. The maneuver is critical for future missions, especially to destinations like Mars, where spacecraft must navigate atmospheric conditions during descent. One of the primary objectives of the fifth Starship test flight was to assess how well the recent improvements to the vehicle's heat shield performed under real-world conditions. The heat shield is a critical component of Starship's design, protecting the spacecraft from the intense heat generated during atmospheric re-entry, where temperatures can exceed 1,600 degrees Celsius. For this flight, SpaceX completely reworked the thermal protection system. The older heat shield tiles were replaced with newer generation materials designed to better withstand the extreme temperatures of reentry. These new tiles are crucial for protecting the vehicle's structure and internal systems from heat damage. In addition, SpaceX added a backup ablative layer around the flaps, which had previously been vulnerable to heat-related damage during reentry. The test flight showed that these changes were largely successful. While there was minor burn through on one of the forward flaps, the damage was far less severe than in previous flights. This indicates that the new heat protection system worked as intended and will continue to be refined for future Starship missions. The success of the flip maneuver not only demonstrated the effectiveness of these design improvements, but also validated Starship's ability to perform in extreme conditions. After completing the flip maneuver, Starship entered the final phase of its descent, the landing burn. This phase is crucial for reducing the spacecraft's speed from hypersonic to subsonic velocities, allowing for a controlled landing. Powered by the Raptor engines, the landing burn involves reigniting the engines after re-entry to slow the vehicle down just before it touches the surface. For Ship 30, the landing burn was a critical component of the mission, ensuring a soft splashdown in the Indian Ocean. The Raptor engines, designed to reignite even after enduring the harsh conditions of re-entry, worked flawlessly during this phase. The precise timing of the landing burn allowed the vehicle to touch down gently in the targeted splashdown zone, demonstrating SpaceX's ability to control the spacecraft with remarkable accuracy. Each Starship test flight builds upon the lessons learned from previous launches, and this fifth flight was no different. The vehicle's performance during the flip maneuver, landing burn, and splashdown demonstrated that SpaceX's ongoing efforts to improve Starship are paying off. The heat protection system in particular showed significant progress, reducing the amount of damage sustained during re-entry. Now, we eagerly await the sixth flight of the Starship Super Heavy. I really hope it happens this year, but let's stay optimistic that SpaceX can learn from the fifth flight and be well prepared for the next one. What are your thoughts? How long do you think it will take SpaceX to schedule Flight 6? Comment below. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. NASA is planning to extend the contract for a critical component of the Space Launch System, SLS, a move that signals the agency's awareness of potential multi-year delays in upcoming missions. The contract pertains to the Launch Vehicle Stage Adapter, LVSA, a crucial piece of the SLS configuration used in the Artemis missions to the Moon. This extension would ensure the continued development of this component, which has played a significant role in NASA's deep space exploration efforts. On August 21st, NASA officially rolled out the LVSA that will be used for Artemis II, the second crewed mission in the Artemis program. This marks an important step forward in preparing for the mission, which will carry astronauts around the Moon and back to Earth. The LVSA was built at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, where much of the SLS core stage development and assembly takes place. The structure was then carefully loaded onto a barge for transport to the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Once at Kennedy, it will be integrated with other key components of the SLS rocket in preparation for the mission. The LVSA is a large, cone-shaped structure that serves a specific and critical function within the overall SLS architecture. Standing 8.4 meters, 27.5 feet tall, it is designed to connect two key stages of the rocket, the core stage and the interim cryogenic propulsion stage, ICPS, which acts as the upper stage on the Block 1 version of the SLS. The base of the LVSA is 8.4 meters wide, the same diameter as the core stage of the SLS, while the top tapers to a narrower 5 meters in width. This taper allows the LVSA to seamlessly integrate the ICPS with the rest of the rocket. The ICPS, in turn, provides the power to boost the Orion spacecraft out of Earth's orbit and toward the Moon. However, the LVSA's role is temporary in the broader SLS program. NASA plans to replace the ICPS with the Exploration Upper Stage EUS on future, more powerful versions of the SLS. The EUS will provide greater thrust and capability, allowing the SLS to carry heavier payloads and travel deeper into space. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.